FaceTime is coming to Android, and we're going to give you a first look at what it looks like.
This is huge news for Android users, and it's one reason why Android users typically would switch to an iPhone, is that they would want to leave Android to get FaceTime. In this case, I think Apple's selling them an awesome new product here.
Yes, sort of.
Sort of.
It's, you know, not the full FaceTime. You can't go into your Android and download the FaceTime app. It just doesn't exist. What you can do is get a link and join in a web browser. So let's show them how to do it.
Let's do it.
I'll open up FaceTime on my iPhone, and here you have this new Create Link button. I'm going to tap on that, and I'm going to share it with John Upphone.
I'll be John Upphone today.
Send it there. Here on our Pixel, we should get that message.
There join my FaceTime. All right, so all I need to do is tap on the FaceTime link.
I'll tap on it as well. There you go. Get a nice shot of our overhead cam here.
There you go. John, continue. So looking at this interface, one of the things that I noticed is that the Apple interface that's built in here looks better than the Android interface, like the rest of it.
Yeah.
The font looks better. It's got this nice opaque background, which is actually very impressive because it's using a web browser. But as you can see, it's really high quality.
That's great.
Look at that. Look at that light in the background there.
Get a behind the scenes look at the studio right now as well.
And the ceiling, as and David ceiling. Said. Yep. So you can see it's a beta right now. You've got a full screen mode. You can mute the microphone, turn that back on, video, use the back camera. And then over here, you can choose the camera you want to use and the microphone you want to use. You can also share the link from an Android, but you just can't start it from an Android. Right. David's iPhone has some additional features, which are called FaceTime camera effects. Let's just
get a quick preview of that. Tap on that star down there, and you got a whole bunch of options. Let's start with filters. And, you know, what if I want to do a comic book? Look like a comic book character.
You sure do.
Sort of. Let's come over here. How about watercolor?
This is no small feat. And obviously, Apple is kind of borrowing from Snapchat here with Snapchat filters, who borrowed from Photoshop. And so it's this big imitation is the sincerest form of flattery, they say.
Michael!
Oh, that's funny.
Michael!
It's also a good way to get sued.
This could be a cool thing. Like you're doing a virtual play, you know, with COVID, everyone's doing it on Zoom. Yeah. What if you had FaceTime and you made it look like a comic book play as opposed to, it adds an extra element of... You know,
you've always
atmosphere.
Had a flair for the theatrical. Yeah.
All right, so let's go back to the original here. Mm-hmm. Another cool thing, how about stickers? What if I want to add a giraffe?
What if? Now you can drag it. This is what I love about this, is it moves around with you. Again, Apple's not the first company to do this, but you just drag it on yourself.
Right in my face there.
There you go. And now it'll stay in your nose, even as you move.
Let's get rid of that.
Okay, Mr. Giraffe Nose.
So I'm going to close out of camera effects here. Another icon you see, it's kind of grayed out right now. It is grayed out right now, is the share screen. It doesn't work with Android, but it does work iPhone to iPhone.
Yes, and who knows, maybe they'll build this into Android eventually.
Let's tap join.
All right, and I'll tap join.
And it says, maybe John would like to join this call.
Maybe. Waiting for others. Did it work?
It did work.
It worked! First time ever. Oh my gosh. Jeez. Okay, I'll mute my microphone.
Wow. That was, we thought it wasn't going to work, but
it's never worked before.
It hasn't worked before. It works now. I think a lot of people tried this out right away and complained, and maybe Apple fixed it pretty quickly.
How about that?
The government actually found someone we're looking for. Yeah, baby. Yeah.
This is the first time that something hasn't worked and then did work during a video.
It's the opposite. Usually things just go wrong.
Yeah, usually things work every time except when we record them.
So it really is a full first look now. I thought it was going to be kind of lame at the end there. We weren't going to be able to show them in the call. But
yeah, we are looking at them. Here's looking at you.
He's looking at you, kid.
Well, how about this now? Now my share screen.
Shows what we know. All right, do it.
Let's tap that. Share my screen.
Ah, it's grayed out.
Yeah, well, good try.
Yeah, I got nothing for you. I can share the link. Pretty cool.
Well, folks,
I can see.
You can start FaceTime in an Android immediately, I suppose.
The quality's pretty good, too. I mean, even on the Android. Obviously, we can't really speak to the quality of the audio at this point, but it seems pretty seamless, I think, compared to Zoom. I mean, you look great. How do I look?
Look good. So one other thing I want to point out, too, while this call is working, if you swipe down to open Control Center on your iPhone, you'll see this video effects and mic mode. I'm going to press and hold on video effects. And you can turn portrait on or off here. Portrait is what makes the blur in the background appear, kind of like the Zoom calls where Apple you know, rip that off. But I would recommend turning on portrait. And it then mic mode. Better. Standard voice isolation and wide spectrum. This is, you know, if there's a bunch of background noise, maybe somebody's vacuuming in the house, so I can do a FaceTime call.
Voice isolation.
Yep.
And if you're trying to share music with somebody, really not a great idea. You're at a concert. You want them to hear the bass, wide spectrum. It'll not filter anything out.
Yeah. So just wanted to point those out. But that is a first look at FaceTime on Android. I'm really happy that it worked.
Me too. This was a pleasant surprise. So let us know what you think. Are you excited to use FaceTime on your Android? Do you think that this interface looks better than the rest of the Android interface? I'm really impressed by Apple. If there's one thing Apple knows how to do, they know how to build a website, because this is no small feat, building a website that works just like a native app. It's pretty amazing.
Yep. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed. Leave a comment down below. Tell us your thoughts. Become a YouTube member.
Yes. We recently started offering channel memberships. In just a few days, we're going to be giving away our first product, which is a 4-pack of AirTags, which is worth $99. Right now, we're up to 11 members. We're going to be shouting everyone out in a video to come out super soon. They won't get this one because we already opened it.
None in there. Yeah. You'll get a new one. Factory sealed.
Yes.
And don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Thanks for watching.